Hi there, welcome to the channel. My name is Alana and I'm the creator of the Health Analytic Insights podcast, where I interview guests and talk all things health informatics.
In this three-part video course, we're going to go over the steps of creating your own clinical business intelligence portfolio project. So as I said in the beginning of the video, I'm the creator of the Health Analytic Insights podcast. I have my master's in biomedical engineering, and I currently work in the health informatics field. So why should you create your own clinical business intelligence portfolio? So you might have noticed during your job search that there are some entry-level roles in the health informatics field which are looking for 1 to 2 years of experience. And this can really result in a frustrating situation and a chicken and egg situation where you need experience to get the job, but the job requires experience. And although getting a job can be equal parts luck and timing, just throwing your resume into the void of LinkedIn or Indeed can make you feel like you're not even moving the needle on getting that first job. So instead, consider creating your own clinical business intelligence portfolio to really stand out from the crowd and have a project that you can speak to with employers, especially if you already have strong clinical experience working maybe as a nurse or a pharmacy technician. Showcasing your technical skills will hopefully help to get you that first entry-level job. So once you follow the steps in this video and created your own clinical business intelligence portfolio, you can either embed the portfolio project in your own professional blog, or you can just hyperlink to it in your resume, or you can just create an account in GitHub and link to that. So before we jump into actually creating the project, I'm just going to go over a few common healthcare metrics that we will be integrating into the dashboard that we're going to create. So some of these metrics include average time to see healthcare provider. This can be described as the average time between when the patient was admitted and when they saw the healthcare provider. And you have the patient satisfaction score. And this can be a survey provided to the patient, which outputs a score on how the patient rates care at the organization. So 1 could be very unsatisfied, to 5 could be very satisfied. You have the patient readmission rate, which could be a metric describing how many patients were readmitted to the hospital or healthcare organization within a 30-day period. And then finally, the average hospital length of stay, which can be the average elapsed time between when the patient was admitted into care and when they were discharged. So each hospital or healthcare organization can determine what is the target values for these KPIs or key performance indicators, as this can vary widely based on the size of the healthcare organization or the location, as well as many other factors. And these metrics can showcase a holistic view of how the healthcare organization is trending over time when it comes to driving improved patient outcomes. So this is the dashboard that we're going to be creating in this clinical business intelligence portfolio. So the final outcome of this clinical business intelligence portfolio will be a Power BI dashboard that's going to integrate these metrics that I just described. And the data set that we'll be using for this portfolio project is just fake dummy data. So you can choose to follow along and build your own dashboard, as I have linked the data set in the description box below. Or you can use other open source data sets that I have linked to as well. So the final result will be able to create this Power BI dashboard, and you can use the functionality called Publish to Web. You'll receive a unique link which you can embed in your own professional blog or just hyperlinked in your resume. And this will give you an opportunity to speak to the technical skills you have developed, specifically the data cleaning methods that we will go over in this video series. So just an overview of the videos that will be in this three-course series. So this is video number 1, an intro to why we are creating this clinical business intelligence portfolio. And I'm going to end off by showing you how to download Power BI. The next video will focus on data cleaning and manipulation, which is oftentimes the majority of the work done by data analysts or healthcare data analysts. And finally, we will wrap up by creating this dashboard and showcasing how you can embed it into a blog. So there are two ways to download Power BI Desktop. You can either go to this website, which I will link to in the description box below, or you can go directly to the Microsoft Store, or you can go directly to the Microsoft Store and search for Power BI Desktop. Search for it, and then you can just download it here. So I will see you in the next video when we open up Power BI Desktop and get to data cleansing and manipulation. See you in the next video.